Hey, I'm Moses.
Hi, I'm Fabian.
Hi, I'm Richard.
Hi, I'm Hannah.
And we're going to Copenhagen. Team arrived late on Saturday night in Copenhagen, but as you can see, the camera's rolling and we're hanging out in a square infamously known as Copenhagen.
I am really excited that the UCL student dream team is going to Copenhagen. The reason being is it's not going to be us, the middle-aged, the elderly statements who are actually going to have to live through climate change. It is the youth, it's the students of today. It's the dream team who are going to have to actually manage this problem and actually become the policymakers of the future.
Now, let's see what's going on over here.
Hi, London. I'm simply here to facilitate the good work that all these students are doing from all these different universities around the world to promote campus sustainability.
We are just designing our poster here.
Okay, so you mean that's a way to what we talked about last night, coordination of people and buildings in the park?
Yeah, the committee recommendations, institutional motivation, funding, implementation.
Go!
Because we used to 200 thousand sheets.
So this is the amount of work they throw away every year or every month or whatever.
This change on their energy consumption and water consumption by adopting policies like this.
Let me just give you a brief overview of what's the actual situation in at UCL. We have an environmental sustainable steering committee, and we have an implementation and management plan concerning CO2 reduction, which says that we want to reduce CO2 emissions by 10%. Energy bills amount to about £6.5 million each year, which corresponds to about 36,000 tons of CO2 emissions. So that tells us of what we can really do. Then we had a look at where do the CO2 emissions really come from. It's mainly from buildings, electricity and heat consumption in buildings. That's why our main focus is on that. And we want to approach this problem from two perspectives. One is the behavioral side and the other one is the technical side. So what we want to do is to give the environmental and energy team at UCL much more power, more resources to actually tackle the problem of energy savings. And how are we going to implement it? First, we want to contact the president of UCL, receive some feedback on it, then try to implement the institutional changes I just described, and then see if we can implement this OPOR system combined with some energy savings measures in order to deliver and meet the carbon reduction plan. Thank you very much.
Just look at the camera. Okay, that's fine.
That's good.